We don't hear much about AIDS in Africa anymore, but the pandemic continues to wreak havoc, devastating communities and leaving millions of orphans. The task of raising those AIDS orphans has fallen largely on African grandmothers, an heroic group of women who are doing the job of a missing generation. Tonight, in partnership with the Stephen Lewis Foundation, we bring you their remarkable story. It's a weight they were never meant to carry. The grandmothers of Africa, poor, disempowered, many of them widows, now having to raise a generation of AIDS orphans. Women like Tulisile Diladla, who are despondent because they have no more to share.
They are crying, we are hungry. Gogo, we are hungry. Ah. It's painful.
It's a story you hear throughout sub-Saharan Africa from women who are often themselves in poor health.
Impilo yami ayingijabulisi njengalabo abanye bafati. Indoda yashona. Abantu bami lababili nabo bashona. Ngathola ukuthi ngiphila neligciwane lembulalave HIV.
In Swaziland, the state only gives money to caregiving women after they turn 60. But many African grandmothers like Tulisile are younger than that, so they get nothing.
Mulapo sabese senda neighborhood K-pop program. Sisita bantwana laba ngamashumi lamane 45.
The real problems are staggering. Sub-Saharan Africa has up to 16 million AIDS orphans, nearly half the population of Canada. Many African governments have been unable or unwilling to help, so grandmothers came forward. Mariam Mulindwa says they need help to carry that burden. Thousands of Canadian grandmothers heard that appeal and have responded with moral support and money. Women like Joanne Page.
The Canadian grandmothers have raised over $21 million. Which sounds like a phenomenal amount of money, and yes, it is, but not enough to cover the thousands of women who still need all kinds of support. They need training, they need counseling, they need grievance support from having lost their children. And what we're finding even now is grandmothers who are saying, I'm unwell, I'm not gonna live much longer. Who's gonna look after my children now? Second time that these children are going to be orphaned.
And that's a prime concern. Who will step in for women like Mariam when they're gone?
Abana bange ne bamulekwa. Nine nyike ku mutima n'omugugu gwe gumu nga bajjajja bannange. Naye mpulira bulungi nnyo nga nkola emirimu egya nakyewa.
Sababu. Tunatuna bakaire tulinokuta walale dobozi tuboneke nti tusindiko okukobera government chichi chetwenda.
To care for the children, the grandmothers need more than money. They need equality under the law, something many African women have never had.
It is beyond description how powerful and how important it is.
Former UN Ambassador Stephen Lewis heads a foundation helping the grandmothers.
Until we break the gender inequality, we will never break the pandemic. And the grandmothers of Africa are the centerpiece of this reality.
African women face inequality in land ownership, housing, and in the justice system, all of which affect their ability to raise children. But the grandmothers are making progress.
The tide is turning.
Joanne Page recalls a visit to the capital of Rwanda, where officials wanted to build a statue in honor of grandmothers.
The design was of a woman bent over, lugging bags, pulling a child behind her, and these women spoke up and said, "That's not who we are. We're strong, and we're vibrant, and we're fighting for our rights. Either you do it the way we look now, or not at all." And in the center is this magnificent statue of a tall woman with her shoulders back and a healthy-looking child holding her hand. That's the kind of voices I was hearing for their strengths.
We, the grandmothers of Africa, speak to you now as the guardians of the future.
Slowly, their voices are being heard in Africa and recently in Canada. Grandmothers learning to speak out for their children's children and for themselves.
We lobby because of this situation we are in. We are old and we are sick. But someone has to take responsibility for the orphans. Africa cannot survive without us. We call on you to act with agency and purpose to support our efforts, secure justice. It is time, and the time is now.